There, got parts of the world to get it out here. Just for reference. Centered on an assembly, the main piece here, that's the mount, is 51.44 by 31.87, let's see if it's 1 1/17 64 by 2 1/32 and 3/16 for thick. This is the one that's putting in the background. Hopefully YouTube doesn't flag this one again. And I have to appeal it again. Sixteenths thread by 47/64 long. Bolt is a 1/8. Invested. I'm just going to hand tighten. You know, I have to follow up with some Loctite on this. This piece is going to need Loctite to work. I'm going to These are just some resin replicas. I'm gonna have to call an outfit and couple outfits. I got some paints on. See if I can score some actual ones. Have asked Mandy if you ever make some cast resin ones online. Or I'm sorry, some forged aluminum ones. This is a machine replica that I managed to find. It works. The resin one I busted. This was off of a supposedly a 750 Magura, but I kind of got my doubts. This is a more modern one. I just had to machine it down. It works. I prefer to do a lot of this stuff by hand. get a motorcycle helmet for that. So. Once you get a screw loose, you can never find it again. Definitely number 10. The only odds it's a phone thread, of course. Basically, you remove the whole rear and you had to machine this piece here, fit a pipe through, and then he used a stone pipe or washer there. This was a piece of thick wall tube. Can't use thin wall, it has to be thick wall so you can do the necessary machining and still maintain structural rigidity. Thank you.
think some Loctite, because this part's just going to keep getting looser from time to time. That's normal wear and tear. Given this all metal, if it breaks, I'd say you could probably do a full disassembly and weld or repair. It is what it is. That's it for the post-carnage report. Other thing to know is this is just meant to look. It's a prison replica at work. Well, it doesn't work. Find a source one that's close to it. No luck yet. This is from Magura. I think it's actually the clutch lever is what some of the folks were finding. Just find them, you can machine them down. Finer stuff you would want to hand thread, do not try to man handle it, that's how stuff works. Got a lime. There you go. This stuff's a lot easier to do. It's not tightening all that. Goal here is to not crush the tube. Now, I'll go see if I got. Basically, the trigger assembly is just one of these. This is just one I have from an arcade unit where I got spare parts. But you literally only have very little movement. You can buy replacement AEG motor gear assemblies. So far in all the checking, there are no aftermarket units given that you can buy those readily, I'm led to believe that these motors like to burn up. And that's just par for the course, I suppose. It's a good habit after you use it for a while to just check and make sure everything's taut. But this bracket is what I mainly had to wait on because I'm using a King TV, which is actually a little closer to the movie rig setup. Goes on like this. This is a 8. I'm a bigger fan of the Torx versus Hex because the Torx aren't so likely to get stripped. Oh, that's much better. I believe it goes like this. Thank you. don't want to get that loose. Those longer ones are a real pain in the ass to tap out. I'm going for function under accuracy and comfort. Let's get you some measurements on this. This is 2564 thick, 1.5 tall, 4 inches wide. Taper is at 1 7/16. I'd say 1.5 the taper's there. It may be a 7/16 on this, that just may have been a machine deal. They work better that way. This is an add-on. I think you can do that with some simple sheet metal, just bend it properly. Cord that plugs in down here. There's a motor compartment for BBs is up here, and then it goes down through a little spring deal in here to the hopper. There's 4 AA's that go in here that are tied to the trigger assembly. So the question is, you know, do you use those to drive the lights so you can still have the trigger? But most cons like to have this stuff completely disabled because there's a few people with issues that like to cause problems and make everyone's life difficult. But it is what it is. I'll still be looking for the proper lever for that. I end up having to make a road trip on it. But I got everything tightened up. Probably gonna have to do some digging on this one. But that. I don't think anyone's taking the time to kind of break it down a little bit, but it is what it is. Have a good night. Check us out on Facebook at theuscm.com. You can check out my YouTube, Cobra_Shipwreck. I'll have it uploaded at both places. Have fun.